We're going on a bear hunt. We're gonna catch a big one. I'm not scared. I am scared. I was terrified. Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be a story time video on the first time I took my kids camping. It was literally horrific. I will never forget it. My kids will never forget it. And I thought that I would just share it with you guys. I kind of brought it up a little bit in Periscope and everyone's like, oh my God, you should do a story time video. So that is what I'm doing right now. So anyway, this story basically took place, I would say, when my youngest was probably in kindergarten or first grade. My kids are 4 years apart, so you do the math and figure out how old they were. But anyway, so I had gone camping in the past just by myself. Like when I was in high school, I went camping with the girls and we had such a good time. And I just remember it being cool and breezy and we went swimming and we stayed one night and everything was fine. And we roasted marshmallows by the campfire and it was like a lot of fun. So when I got invited to go camping with a whole bunch of families from where my kids went to school, I was super excited. There were three other families that were going. One of the families had, let me see if I can remember, one of the families had a girl in my youngest daughter's grade and they had two kids. The other family, and that was a mom and a dad, so mom and a dad, two kids. The second family had a mom and a dad, two kids, boy and a girl. And the third family had a mom and a dad, three kids, and it went girl, girl, boy. So anyway, here is Miss Angela. I don't have any camping gear in sight. And we decided to go camping with all of these families. Where we went was Calumet County Park. I don't know if any of you guys, local people from Wisconsin, are familiar with that campground, but I had never gone there before. So this was all a new experience to me. Like I said, I didn't have any, you know, camping gear. I didn't have any sleeping bags or anything like that. So we went shopping and we got the sleeping bags and we borrowed a tent and we basically just kind of like made do with what we had. And sorry, I was getting like notifications on my phone. I should have turned those off before I did this video. But anyway, so we were set to go. Everything was great. Now I remember kind of keeping track of the weather and kind of like watching and noticing that it was going to be extremely hot. I don't do well in the heat. My kids don't really care. They could do well anywhere basically. But I like at that time did not do well in the heat at all. I still don't do well. When I was younger, I was fine. But like I think as you get older, you know, you sweat in places that you never thought you could sweat. But anyway, so I remember us getting to the campgrounds and I remember it being super hot. We checked in, we paid for everything, and I think we were staying two nights, so I knew it wasn't going to be that bad. There were porta potties. You did have to pay for the water to take a shower, which I thought was kind of odd, but like I said, I've never been camping before, so I never really had an idea as to what to expect from this park. And I thought there was going to be water. Like, I thought we were, I don't know why, I thought our tents were going to be like right by the water. No, the water was a hike away. And we were in an area where there was literally no breeze. There was no wind, no breeze, 95 degrees outside and humid. So picture me, never really gone camping before, a lady of this girth, with the kids going camping. I started sweating immediately when I got there. We had to like set all of our tents up and everything. So, okay, got through that. Everything was fine. The ranger came. I remember the ranger coming and his name coincidentally was Ranger Rick. And I remember Ranger Rick coming and talking to us. And I was a little bit apprehensive about animals because as you guys know, I'm literally obsessed with wildlife and the DNR and everything. So Ranger Rick came and I talked to him about like snakes, about like bear, about deer, like what could happen. And he just basically assured us that everything was fine. And these other people that we went camping with, they were like expert campers. Like, so I think they were kind of like, you know, what is she talking about type of thing, but I don't know, whatever. I just wanted to be prepared in my experience of camping. So
Nighttime comes. We're roasting marshmallows. I remember us looking up at the sky and seeing the satellite go past. Like it was, I don't even know. We saw a lot of stars, which in Wisconsin, when we look up in the sky, we see a lot of stars here too. But anyway, some people in the bigger cities don't. So we get into our tents. It's time to go to bed. All the couples that we were with, they were like couples. So it was like mom, dad, mom, dad, mom, dad, Angela. Anyway, I didn't have a boyfriend at the time, so I just went by myself. But anyway, so, okay, we go in the tent. I'm hot as a mofo bitch. Like at this point, I literally walked to the bathroom. I even took a nighttime shower as I'm like putting my quarters in, paying for my ice cold water because they didn't have warm water. And like I was still super hot. By this point, my legs were chafing, like my thighs were rubbing together and chafing. I probably had a rash. It was awful. So we finally get in the tent and like the kids are exhausted from running around and doing whatever, and they fall asleep right away. Literally, these people were probably sick of me because all I did was complain the whole time about the heat. But anyway, so we go to bed, and I remember not falling asleep. Like literally, I think it was like probably 11 o'clock at night. Everybody kind of turned in. I couldn't fall asleep. I was sitting in my tent with my eyes wide open. The kids were like sprawled out on top of their sleeping bags because it was so hot and they were already passed out. And all of a sudden I could see shadows from the moon and creatures all about. Now I knew well enough to keep food up. We actually took all of our food that like couldn't be in the coolers and we tied it to a thing up at the tree, I don't know, whatever. So I had no food in my tent whatsoever. I might have had some Bath and Body Works spray or something, I don't know. Anyway, there was no food in the tent. So all of a sudden I see at 2 o'clock in the morning, shadows. And when you see shadows in your tent from the moon, you don't know if this animal beast is like right by your tent or if it's far away and it just looks like it's close. So I'm thinking to myself, I'm alarmed, but there's three men around me with their wives and the kids. Everything should be okay. And I'm hot and I'm sweating and I'm like almost done with life in general at this point. But anyway, all of a sudden, the zipper on our tent starts like flicking up, like the little thing that you grab on for the zipper. I can hear it and I can like see something is flicking it up with a little finger. And I'm just like, oh hell no. Something's trying to get into my tent. I start screaming. The kids are like, what? What's going on? Like, what's happening, mom? Something is getting in our tent. So I start screaming. I quickly open up the tent and look outside, and there's raccoons running all in our campsite. Like, you know, so we had our tents all around the campfire. At this point, I start screaming. All of the men, all three of the men, the wives, which I knew the wives very, very well. I knew one of the husbands very, very well. The other two, I didn't really know that well. All came out in their privies, their underwear. Like literally tidy whities came out at me. The men were all like, oh my God, what's going on? You know, it's like 2 o'clock in the morning. And I'm just like, I have to leave. I have to get everything together and I gotta get out of here. And everybody's like, no, Angela, you know, just calm down. Everything's, I'm like, no, I have a rash. I am hot. It is still 90 degrees. It had not cooled down by this point. I am sweating. There are creatures trying to get into my tent. I'm gonna die. So at this point, there's like a lot of commotion going on. Everybody's outside of their tents. I'm all in a fluster. I'm starting to get all of our chairs and pack it up. I'm starting to like get all of our clothes and put them. I brought luggage because I didn't know. I started putting all of our clothes and luggage, shaking everything out at 2 o'clock in the morning. All of a sudden, we see this car come by, Ranger Rick. I'm like, Rick, I have to leave. I have had it with this camping experience. We are out. I remember one of the moms saying, you're really going to leave like at 2 o'clock in the morning. We were 45 minutes away from home. I was done. I was completely spent. So I packed up the kids. I packed up all of our stuff at 2 o'clock in the morning and I left. And I have never been camping since. And actually on our way home, we saw a dead raccoon in the road and deer were all over the place. It was a mess. And I just needed to get out of there. I have never gone camping again, nor will I ever. Maybe in the fall. Maybe camping in the fall wouldn't be so bad, I guess, because it's a lot cooler. And I think it was just the heat maybe that got to me. I don't know. But anyway, you guys, that was my camping experience. I hope you enjoyed my story. Thank you guys so much for watching. And I will see you guys all soon with other, hopefully, story time videos. See you guys later, everyone. Bye-bye.